Could eating grilled meat cause cancer? Science says yes. Two potent cancer-causing group of chemicals, heterocyclic amines and polyaromatic hydrocarbons, are formed when muscle meat, including beef, pork, fish and poultry, is cooked using high-temperature methods such as pan frying or grilling directly over open flames. Whatever the type of meat, if it is cooked at high temperatures, especially above 300 degrees Fahrenheit or 150 degrees centigrade, as happens while grilling or pan frying, or that are cooked for a long time, tend to form more heterocyclic amines. If well done, grilled or barbecued chicken and steak all have high concentration of heterocyclic amines. Heterocyclic amines are also formed in fried foods, specifically fried meats. Heterocyclic amines are formed when amino acids, sugars, and creatinine, a substance found in muscle, react at high temperatures. In particular, an increase in 3 heterocyclic amines was found with increasing frying temperatures and cooking duration. 2-amino-3,8-dimethylimidazole-4,5-p-quinoxaline, 2-amino-3,4-8-trimethylimidazole-4,5-f-quinoxaline, 2-amino-3-methylimidazole-4,5-f-quinolone. Polyaromatic hydrocarbons are formed when the fat and juices from the meat grilled directly over a heated surface or open fire drip onto the surface or fire, causing the flames and smoke. The smoke contains polyaromatic hydrocarbons that then adhere to the surface of the meat. Polyaromatic hydrocarbons can also be formed during other food preparation processes such as smoking of meats. Cooking methods that expose meat to smoke contribute to polyaromatic hydrocarbon formation. Now let's see what polyaromatic hydrocarbons and heterocyclic amines can do to our health. In laboratory experiments, heterocyclic amines and polyaromatic hydrocarbons have been found to be mutagenic. That means they cause changes in DNA that may increase the risk of cancer. In many experiments, rodents fed a diet supplemented with heterocyclic amines developed tumors of the breast, colon, liver, skin, lung, prostate, and some other organs. Rodents fed polyaromatic hydrocarbons also developed cancers, including leukemia and tumors of the gastrointestinal tract and lungs. International Agency for Research in Cancers has listed many polyaromatic hydrocarbons as human cancer-causing chemicals. There is scientific evidence that people who work with polyaromatic hydrocarbons have increased risk of lung, skin, and bladder cancer. Researchers found that high consumption of well-done, fried, or barbecued meats was associated with increased risk of colorectal, pancreatic, and prostate cancers. In support of these experimental studies, epidemiology linkages between the consumption of high-temperature cooked foods and human cancer have been reported by scientists. Fortunately, there are simple steps that can minimize the potential risks of eating grilled meats while maintaining the smoky flavor that so many people enjoy. The keys are to minimize both the amount of the time that meat is cooked at the high heat and the amount of the smoke in contact with the meat. Here are some tips. Avoiding direct exposure of meat to an open flame or hot metal surface and avoiding prolonged cooking times, especially at high temperatures, can help reduce these toxic chemical formation. Using the microwave oven to cook meat prior to exposure to high temperatures can also substantially reduce heterocyclic amine formation by reducing the time that meat must be in contact with high heat. Continuously turning meat over on a high heat source can substantially reduce heterocyclic amine formation compared with just leaving the meat on the heat source without flipping it often. While eating, remove the charred portions of the meat and do not use the gravy made from the meat drippings. If you find this information useful, please give a like. And if you are looking for more such information, please subscribe to my channel. Thank you.